Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? And Happy New Year. I think this is, January 4th, 2012. All right. Now, I haven't done a video for a little while, and I want to share with you some Ubi stuff. A viewer wrote in yesterday and asked about they can get into sleep paralysis, and a lot. It kind of happens naturally. And recently they've started moving in and out, and they sort of parts of their body, but stuck at the hips. And do I have any techniques or any suggestions or tips for what happens if you can get partly out of the body, but you get stuck in some places? And I go, I got a few things I can share about that. Like, you get sleep paralysis, which means your body has fallen asleep. You have stayed awake. Way to go. And you may or may not feel the vibrations. We'll talk about vibrations later. But there you are, and you can lift your head out of your body, right? Your second body out of your physical body. Might be able to look around. You can hear shit that's not physical. And half the fucking time, especially when you're new at it, it's something scary. It's scary because it's fucking scary. Or it's scary because it's weird and new. If you see some creepy looking thing in the corner, floating over by your chest of drawers or some cardboard box or some shit, or something, and you're looking, you've lifted up out of your body, it's dark in the room, it's got that twilight looking thing. It's like we have some kind of magical night vision when we move out of our physical body, because we can see in a room that normally should be black or dark, right? So anyway, you look around, you see some creepy thing floating over there, and it's got pointy ears and scary looking fucking eyes and shit. And you go, and you get all scared, right? You know, it's like your first or second, and you get all scared. It doesn't mean that thing is harmful. It means it's strange and unusual, and you get scared. It's surprising. So we can get scared because of the unusual or the surprising or fright. And it shakes us out of the zone, and we go running back for the security of physical reality, our physical body. We want to wake back up in the physical world where things don't go floating around in the fucking dark, scaring the living shit out of us. Okay, so this was kind of, that was freaky. Sometimes people will see stuff sitting on their chest. I mean, they wake up and they go, Yeah. And there's different kinds of things that will do that. But definitely happens. Some people have told me that those things, grab them by the throat, choke on them, sit on their chest, they can't breathe, all kinds of freaky shit. And sometimes they're just sitting on your chest or scaring the crap out of you. But all manner of things can happen in this sleep paralysis state, which really means you are awake and your physical body is asleep, and you've made the phase transition. You're out of phase or out of sync with physical reality because you're awake and your physical body is asleep. It's kind of a natural phenomenon. Now, let's get to that part where one particular viewer, I won't mention your name just because some people, you mentioned my name. Ah, I know, sorry. And other people, they don't care. So, whatever. So, there you are, stuck at the hips. You can't get out. You can lift up. Sometimes you can lift up this way, but you're stuck at the hips. Sometimes you can lift your feet out, stuck at the hips. Well, one thing you can do, I could have made this a 3-minute video, by the way. One thing you can do is, before you actually go into sleep paralysis and experience being stuck at the hips or stuck anywhere else, before you go in it, you can lay in bed and practice imagining moving your hips out of your physical body. Just kind of imagine lifting, just like you experience when you're in sleep paralysis for real. If you wake up and you imagine that, your feet float up and it sticks at the hips. Well, when you practice, imagine your feet floating up, but this time in your imagination, imagine your hips unsticking, and then imagine, your torso lifting, and then your neck and your head, and just imagine lifting up. Okay. Practice that before you go into sleep paralysis. That's one tip. Another tip is the theory that where you are stuck, you can't release from your physical body. It has to do with, it's a theory. It has to do with the energy, the meridian or the chakra, minor chakra, major chakra. there's that chakra is blocked and not spinning right, or the energy is not up to speed. It's cluttered with negative energy or something going on in that chakra. So before you go to bed at night, you can relax and close your eyes and do some visualization or imaginary conceptual stuff of clearing the chakra or that energy place where your second body is sticking in your physical body. So if it's at the hips, it'd be the sex chakra and the root chakra most likely. So you could imagine doing your and that'd have to be another video on exactly all the different kinds of things you can do to clear up your chakras. But basically, you can focus on that chakra and flow it some love and healing energy, and imagining that it's clear, it's the right color. Sex chakra is orange, root chakra is red, and that the energies are flowing well through those. And your love and imagination as you focus on those chakras are enough right there to start clearing the chakra and increasing the vibration of that chakra in such a way that maybe your first and second bodies will not stick together when you try to lift out, and just at the hips, it'll lift out easier. So, there's that. Another trick or a technique is to practice demo here. This is your body laying down like this. Roll side to side like you're laying in bed, and you're stuck at the hips here. Well, imagine or practice moving or rolling back and forth like a log rolling back and forth. You want to roll out of your body, your physical body, your second body. And it's a thing you can imagine doing during the real sleep paralysis and you feel stuck. And it's something you can practice kind of like dry run before you fall asleep and before you go into sleep paralysis. You can just imagine rocking back and forth, practice doing that. Okay. And that's one of the classic techniques that help us unstick from our physical bodies. And lastly, one of the theories about why do we stick to the physical body? I personally haven't found any clear, definitive dissertation on why we stick, especially at a wrist or joints or neck, feet, ankles, whatever. I haven't read anything definitive on why that occurs, but I do have my own theories. Let me share it with you. And then we'll wrap this motherfucker up. Okay, all right. Our physical body is kind of like a magnetic field for our second body. It's like magnetic attraction. It's like, I noticed this sometimes when I've gotten out of body and I'm it's like trying to pull out of the physical body, it's like trying to pull through molasses or thick goo. It's like hard. But then you get further you get away, I mean just you get about a foot away, all of a sudden the attraction is much less. You get 2 feet away and it's almost non-existent. And you get far away and you don't even feel an attraction. But if you're like really close to it, it goes like that, just like a magnet. The closer you are, the stronger that thing is. And so it's same coming out. You get just a little, if you get far out of the way, then it gets real easy, right? Okay. So if you're stuck at the hips, we can imagine that the chakra, or wherever you're stuck, those chakras are cluttered with negative energy, or you might call it non-physical particles, and it's kind of like metal, or more magnetic stuff than should normally be there. Because if you can get out from all your other body parts, or you can easily separate, but this one place, no, it could be that there's too much mental or emotional clutter or negative energy in those chakras or in that body part, the physical body part. Okay, so if you do some work to clear up the negative energy in these various body parts, then that might clear it up enough so now that it has the right amount of a more balanced magnetic like attraction, so it's not overly magnetic or overly powerful holding you in as you try to get out. Does that make sense? Okay, so that's what you can do. You can try if you get stuck when you're trying to get out of body and your second body gets stuck at the hips, or if you get stuck anywhere else. These are some of the techniques you can try. Hope they work for you. And anybody else that tries any of this, you know, your feedback is appreciated. Okay? So, good luck, everyone. And I will talk to you later.